Hi guys, this video is the second in a series of videos that show you how to make the desktop 5-axis CNC machine. Many people said that it would be better to increase the technical information since the last video was released. This time, I will introduce the problems and countermeasures I faced while making this small cute machine. Watch this video, you can see how parts of this small CNC machine are made at home. If you're actually thinking of building a machine as small as I made, you might not waste time like I did. The content of this video is like this. After watching this video, please decide if it is useful for you. If you find it useful, subscribe to this channel. In the previous video, I explained the problem that the center of the y-axis stroke of this machine is a lot of offset from the center of the c-axis. This problem makes it difficult to machining. There are two causes. One is this angle frame interferes with the spindle. The other is that the linear guide block has reached the end of the linear guide. This structure needs to be improved. Let's see it with a 3D model for easy understanding. I will show you how to change this structure so that the y-axis can be moved more in the minus direction. Remove this part. Remove this column unit and install it in the opposite direction. Lower the linear guide by 10 mm. Install the brackets to reinforce the columns. After this modification, the y-axis stroke will move in the 15 mm minus direction than before. One method of processing tap holes without shifting is gauging. First, process the M3 tap in one place to fix the linear guide so that it can make tap hole following to the bolt hole of the linear guide. Normally, the pilot hole of the M3 tap is 2.5 mm. But it is strongly recommended to use a 2.6 mm drill so that the tap does not break. Because the M3 tap breaks easily. It is almost impossible to pull out a broken tap. There are three types of taps. I strongly recommend using taper taps. This is because the taper tap is difficult to break because it has less resistance during tapping. This is a tap that I broke before. When the tap breaks, another important thing breaks. It's your heart. If that part is important, you will be even more depressed. This is a tool for removing broken taps. It fits in the three grooves of the tap broken and turns the tap to remove it. But in my experience, it's almost impossible to remove it out. But that's better than nothing. The bolt hole for M3 is 3.5 mm. Since the outer diameter of the M3 bolt is 3 mm, the clearance is only 0.25 mm on the left and right of the bolt. I will adjust the linear guide using this 0.25 mm clearance later. If there is no clearance, adjustment is not possible. So it is not possible to make an accurate machine. If you process the parts with the CNC machine used in a factory, you can easily meet the accuracy of about plus or minus 0.05 millimeters. But, it is difficult to make holes accurately in such an environment at home. Once it is misaligned, it cannot be corrected. Like this case, this method is effective. Remove the cutting chips in the tap holes with a 2.5 mm drill. I haven't used it recently, but this is a fixture for processing taps vertically. Using the 3 mm drill hole as a guide, tap the first 2 mm to 3 mm. This is also the tap do not broken. Down. The bracket has been completed, but I haven't installed it yet. These are the 3D models used this time. The 3D model data is posted on the website. I attached a link in the remarks column. It for free download. It may be charged or deleted in the future. I think, better to do earlier. The data will be revised in the future, so please consider it as reference data. How was it? Did you enjoy it? You watched this video until the end. I think, this means you interested this video. I recommend that you press the like button and subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss the next video. I wanted to show the XY axis adjustments in this video, but the video has become too long, so I'll show it in part 3. Please comment what you felt when you watched this video. I look forward to your comments. See you later.